We're trying something new. I'll tell you later.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to Center for Spiritual Living Hawaii. My name is Michelle May, and I'm a licensed practitioner on the Board of Trustees, and I would love to invite all of you to find your seats.
I'll be sharing.
We're trying something new.
You can hear the red laughing behind me.
Well, welcome. We've had a lot going on this month. Would you agree?
Yes.
Yes, and it's been great. We've had amazing turnouts. Lots of people came for caroling and for the ladies' party, and it's just a wonderful way. We always have things going on here, which is fabulous. But there's just such a celebratory feeling at this time of light and spirit. So thank you for joining us, and there's more. We still have lots going on. When you first walked in, you may have seen the boutique that's out there. That's going to be available after service and then next week as well. If you need any little Christmas gifts, they've all been donated. So all the proceeds go to CSL to help keep us going, keep the lights on, keep the music happening, and all the events that we do. So shop, shop, shop. Shop, shop, shop. And Roseanne will be out back. Maureen is out back. Malia's out back. So there's plenty of ladies to help you shop. So please take advantage of that. More flowers. Come on down.
Yeah, they would look lovely right by the revs.
Yep, we can put them right by the revs. Thank you, Arlene. Aw, beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you.
We've got flowers everywhere. That's so beautiful. All right. So this week we'd like to invite you and let you know about Power Talking from the Heart. This is the third edition, and what this is when people from you and the congregation come up and share from your hearts. We'll have three lovely people who will be coming up. Reverend Diane will be one, Meg Stouter will be another, and Stephanie Starrett will be the other, and they're going to be all sharing about the gift and what that means to them. So please come support them. Come love them up as they are up here. And that's going to be Wednesday, 6:30 to 8 o'clock. So come and join us for that. We will have regular service next Sunday, the 23rd, and an additional candlelight service for Christmas Eve. So we do have back-to-back services next week. It will be different. The Christmas Eve one will be different than what we do here on Sunday. There'll be lots of music, inspiration, candles. It's a really beautiful way to just come together as a family and community. So join us. That's going to be from 6 to 7 on Monday evening, December 24th. So come for Christmas Eve. And then Spiritual Living Circles, they happen. This month is going to be Kalaheo on the 19th with Rebecca DeRoos from 4 to 5, and in Princeville with Anna Myers on December 26th from 3 to 4. And there's more info on the programs that you received when you came in. Now, every year, we always have something to do with giving and being able to share from our abundance. And now I would like to actually call up Reverend Diane to share about one of the projects that she's doing for as the outreach coordinator.
Good morning. We are having a holiday food drive for the Kauai Independent Food Bank this year. You might have seen the gift wrap boxes at the front by the information table. Those are for you to bring donations this week, next week, and the following week, because we will be donating that at the end of the year. So we'll be collecting food and donations until December 31st. And I've had a couple people ask me, can they just give money to the Independent Food Bank? And I want to let you know that a $100 gift, a check or cash donation to the Kauai Independent Food Bank will go a little further than if you went and spent $100 at Costco to donate to the food bank, because they can purchase items that they need in particular, and they can get them at below retail prices. So if it's easier for you just to give me cash or check to donate to Kauai Independent Food Bank, please feel free to do that, as well as if you'd prefer to bring goodies, we will get that to them as well. And as you know, we are replenishing their supplies. They supplied people after the floods in April in a big way. They were there for the community. And so now we are replenishing their coffers so that they're ready for who needs them next. So talk to me after service. Just put your goodies in the box if you'd like. Hand me a check. It's all good. Thank you.
How about a round of applause for Reverend Diane and for everybody who's already donated? And if you are bringing goodies, just note that they're unopened, unperishable, and unexpired. That has all come from experience. All right. So you may have received letters from the Revs for the holidays, and then also talking about our pledge drive, which is just so that we as a center can do our budget for next year. If you did not receive this letter, we have a stack of envelopes at the back, and one of the Malama ladies will be there to help you find them if you need them. And it's just a way to really help know where we are, because we are moving forward. We are moving forward towards our vision, and it's just good for us to know for planning purposes. And in that vein, it's also a really great time to just invite you to consider becoming a member of Center for Spiritual Kauai if you are not already. And really what that entails is just making a commitment to your spiritual growth for yourself, but then wanting to have CSL Kauai be your home and be your family. And you can see me after service if you have any questions about that. And we're going to do a beautiful ceremony and a welcoming to all new members on the last Sunday of the month. We figured that it's a really great nourishing way to start off 2019 for those who would like to just become officially a part of the community and of CSL family. And then one last thing, this is a call out for help. We have our Sacred Journey that's coming up in January, completely sold out, yay! Which is really great, really exciting. It's a week-long event that we do, but we have one event that we are needing help with. If you have access to, you know anybody, or have any insights on ukuleles, we need to borrow or rent. We don't need to buy them, but borrow or rent for one of the events that we're going to do. So you can see the reverends, myself after service if you have an in on that. And we can, okay, great. We've already got, I feel like an auctioneer. And we've got Emma in the front, and we've got anybody else, and Suzette too, and Omarosa, and Charles. No, okay. Awesome. But that'd be very helpful. Because again, the Sacred Journey is a fundraiser for CSL. Pretty much everything we do here is a fundraiser for CSL, because everything that we contribute comes to, again, what I was sharing before, keeping us moving. All right. Well, thank you for your kind attention. And I will invite Reverend Rita and Reverend Patrick up with a round of applause.
And I always appreciate you, Michelle, for keeping those announcements moving, because you are good at doing
if
that.
If you all saw what I saw from up here, you would not be able to keep a straight face. But it's going to really help me through the whole service.
Because if you'll just look back at the camera, this is just too much. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
There we go. I just couldn't even believe it. Oh, and over here, too. Oh, God.
Okay. You ready? Okay, where are we? I'm going to light a candle here.
Okay, so let's just take a deep breath. Let's let it all go and just center here and now as we light our peace candle. Let's bring our attention to our beautiful hearts. Get away from the busyness of our minds and just breathe into that heart space. Slow down our breath. Bring our mind into our heart space. Allow it to connect. And we'll let our heart lead the way. In compassion, in caring, in gratitude, in appreciation for peace on earth. Let's take a moment of silence. And so I know that as we have taken this moment, we have sent out a ripple into the pond of life that extends out from our heart to all the hearts in the world, with that knowing of peace And I know and claim that it is felt and it is manifest right here and right now, already in the mind of good and in the mind of God, in our mind and all minds. And so it is. Thank you for taking that time. It really does make a difference. I know it. So here you are at Center for Spiritual Living Kauai, where we practice the science of mind and spirit that these days is called quantum physics. And we understand that there's a field of energy, a field of life force that we all are part of, all in. It is the very essence of our being, and we get to affect it in any moment with the power of our hearts and our minds working together for good. And so as we come here to celebrate that, we just recognize all of us as that divine presence, as that field of energy, as that one mind, whatever we want to call it, it's the same thing. And just experiencing it in an even greater way every moment and allowing ourselves to accept the greatness and the blessing of who and what we are. So thank you for being here today. I am so grateful. Yeah.
Yes, we are. And I don't know if we took a chance, I mean, moment to say Maria Cristina is behind the wonderful piano today, and we just love her. But here's the exciting part of what's happening. Who's here for the first time? Don't try to run. Don't try to hide. We know who you are. Oh, is there someone over here that I saw with? No. Okay, great. So you think Santa's got a list? We have some information on you that we're going to share with everyone, and I hope you don't mind, because we know you've been good, not naughty. So we have something we need to share with you. Are you ready? All right, everyone, let's tell them what we know.
You are magnificent.
You are magnificent. You are magnificent.
Aww. That was so beautiful. Your impression was so beautiful. It was like, All righty then. Yes, I am magnificent. I'm glad you recognize me. Okay, we know that about you because what? We know it about who? Ourselves. So let's all join together and tell ourselves who we are.
I am magnificent.
Now, if you'll look behind you, there's two strange, wonderful, spiritual men back there. And there's also a camera that's allowing everyone to see what's going on here and to feel this wonderful energy that is in this room. But we know that they're magnificent also. And we have Jeannie. I feel like we have Jeannie out there. We have Jeannie Stone, who's actually new to watching us on the weekend. She watched us last weekend, and I want to say hello to her today. And we'll say hello to everybody by letting them know who they are. Are you ready?
You are magnificent.
Now look to your left, to your right. I don't care where you look. Just let somebody know. Who are they? I know Elizabeth is magnificent. I know you are.
You are.
Okay, everyone, let's get up on our magnificent feet and have our opening song. Woo! All right, you little lights, let's shine.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. No more living in fear, we're gonna let it shine. No more living in fear, we're gonna let it shine. No more living in fear, we're gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Ooh, all I know is right here, right now, you are shining so bright that I could use some sunglasses, because there is some bright light happening in here, and it all comes from where? It comes from within, and it is moving through each and every one of us. I see it, I feel it, I accept it, I am it, and that light is divine. It is a frequency that is so high that it just keeps shining and shining and shining. So I know that today we are here on purpose. We are here on divine purpose. That frequency is just shining right through us right here and right now. So what I know is that today, this moment, the only moment that has never happened before like it is happening right now, is happening with light and love and freedom and safety. So knowing that, we just let it go with a big mahalo. Can I hear mahalo?
Mahalo.
Can I hear mahalo?
Mahalo.
And let's let it go, because and so it is. Shine.
All around the world, we're gonna let it shine. All around the world, we're gonna let it shine. All around the world, we're gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. This bright light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This bright light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This bright light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Pretty bright in here, man.
Good morning. My name is Roseanne Jones, and I'm a licensed certified CSL practitioner. And it's my honor today to lead us into meditation. So if you could bring down that shining light a little bit, because we're going into that very quiet space, that space within. So if you'd like to get comfortable in your chairs, know that you are in a safe space, and know that you can let go of anything that happened an hour ago, a minute ago, and also not think about what's happening in the future, but be in this moment. And I have a seed thought if you choose to take it into the meditation. And it's a seed thought by the Lebanese-American poet and mystic, Khalil Gibran. Love, it surrounds every being and extends slowly to embrace all that shall be. Love, it surrounds every being and extends slowly to embrace all that shall be. Enjoy your time.
Thank you.
It surrounds every being and extends slowly to embrace all that should be. And what I know is that there is one power in the universe. And this universal power goes by many names. Call it what you will, it does not matter. But I know that this spirit resides in everything it created. And that means it resides in me and expresses through me. And it resides in each person within my voice and beyond. For that spirit is expressing through each of us at every moment of our lives. And what I know is that the first gift the spirit brings us is love. For love is that power that overcomes all, overcomes darkness. It is the light of love. And I know that love works in and through us in so many ways. And I know that love expresses for more clarity, more perfect understanding of all the relationships we have. And I know that love works in our bodies, in our very cells, in our being, in our hearts, in our minds, to bring us perfect health, to make our creative expression become the highest that we can be, each of us. And what I do know is that this love propels all the blessings that we want to see in our lives, so we get to choose. And the blessings of prosperity, abundance, peace of mind, joy, a joyous spirit, all of these are ours to unwrap. So right now I declare that they are unwrapped for each of us to have, to hold, to be. And I release my word into that law that always says yes to our innermost beliefs as we say together. And so it is.
Our mantra is in your program, and the words are very simple, but packed full of meaning.
I am that I am. I am that I am. I am that I am. I am. I am.
Thank you, Roseanne. Thank you, Maria Christina. Thank you, Etika Luckett and Lisa Ferrara, who wrote that song, I Am That I Am. What powerful words. And when we truly take them in, there is nothing that we can't face, nothing that we can't move through, nothing that we can't do, nothing that we can't have, nothing that we can't be. With those words, because it says it all. We are that power and presence and life force moving and living and breathing through everything. And I'm going to look back at those two back there, and I'm just going to, if you hear me giggling, that's what it is. That's okay. So,
Joy.
And I'm appreciating joy a lot. So the topic today is about unwrapping gifts.
the gift, and it has a lot of meanings. I don't know about you, but when I was a little girl, I always looked for my parents where they hid the Christmas presents. One time I found them, and my brothers and sisters and I, and we found them, and they were hidden way up on this shelf. But when we got to find them, we didn't want to open them because we knew that it would ruin everything. So we just left them there and let Santa Claus do his thing. And Christmas was more special that way. So I'm a present shaker, too. I like to shake things. And somebody left a present under my tree the night of the caroling. And I was like, should we open it now? No, Patrick's like, let's wait. So I think the gifts of life are kind of like that. We want to open them right away when we're in the middle of something, or we want to try to figure out what they are. But sometimes when we're in the middle of something difficult, we don't see the gifts at that time. And what I've noticed for myself is that I have to just be really patient with myself, really loving and kind with myself, and really have a lot of faith that when something comes up that's very difficult to understand or anything like that, or I'm moving through something that I have to face that maybe I don't want to, that I just have to be patient because I understand, because of this teaching, and I am so grateful for this teaching, that allows me to know that in every moment I have a choice at what I'm going to do. I have a choice at how I'm going to react. I have a choice of knowing that something great is happening, even though I might not know what it is, and it might seem weird to me and just not make any sense. But I know, I really do know and have that faith. So it's about being patient with myself. This week I had like this idea about joy. For those of you who haven't been here before, I've been experiencing the transition of a dear friend. And I had this, opened up the Science of Mind textbook written by Ernest Holmes, our founder, and there was a passage that day about joy. And it said, joy has come to live with me. How can I be sad? I do so love thy presence, which is joy within me. I shall give myself to thee and remain with thee, for thou art complete and satisfying. I find fulfillment and joy forevermore. I am filled with the spirit of joy. And so then I turned to the prophet, the book by that you quoted today, Kahil Gibran Jibran, however he pronounces, where he says, your joy is your sorrow unmasked. And then I realized that joy is always there. And so I said, we have this thing called spiritual mind treatment that we do. It's our tool for healing. It is our tool. It's a affirmative prayer where we know the truth about something. And I said, if you claim what you want, you have to believe that it's coming, that it's there. So I claimed a joy. I claimed that joy was there with me, even though I couldn't feel it right now, that it is there. And I expect it to unfold because I claimed it. And so I just have to sit with whatever it is until it reveals itself, knowing that it will. So to me, that's a way of waiting to unwrap a gift. Or you're unwrapping it, but it's an unwrapping that happens slowly, like it's a process. Or it could happen suddenly, and then one day you just get it. And so that's what I've been working with this week, and it's really been helping me through this. And we had a wonderful workshop on forgiveness this week. And the people that attended it, we just really had a really great night. And it was something was very prevalent right now for me is the idea of forgiveness in the world. We're going to show a film at the end of the month called Fumble Talk. I'm probably not pronouncing it right. It's about an African village in that has this thing they do, which is a project about reconciliation to bring peace into the world. And they just have this thing about forgiveness, that they have to have an apology from the person, then they forgive them, and then life goes on. And they do it so easily and effortlessly, but it's because they want peace. They don't want to live in the torment of unforgiveness. So they do this thing, and then they dance together. It's like, just like an amazing thing. I'm going to read more about it, too, because it's very fascinating to me. But I also, in order to unwrap the gift of life, you have to be able to forgive, because you have to be able to not see the gift in things, because you can't always see them, but expect that there will be a gift eventually, like I said before. But if you stay in the sorrow of it and in the pain of it and just keep wallowing there, then you're never going to find the gift. So you move in, you move out at your own pace. So I also have been reading Greg Braden, and he has a wonderful book that I'm going to get for us here because it's great. It's about prayer. And there's something in it that he calls the blessing. And so if you have something in your life, I wrote about it in my blog this morning, that in order to be able to live in the gift of the experience, you have to be able to bless it. And this is a private practice. You don't do it in public. You don't do it. It's a journey practice. And he says, you have to ask yourself, am I ready to move beyond a gut reaction or old belief that someone must pay or that I need to get even in order to right a wrong? If not, your journey is to find out why you would want to hold on to the hurt that leads to the very suffering you're trying to free, to heal. So in other words, in order to do this blessing for yourself, for whatever is going on in your life, you have to be willing to say, I'm willing to let go of whatever it is and just allow myself to heal. If you're not willing, then you need to find out why you're not willing, because in finding out why, you're probably going to find out a lot of stuff about yourself that you might need to know, and so you can move on with your life. Because the whole point about life is not to stay stuck in places. Everything's an experience. I'm beginning to learn that really and really feel it, that everything in life is an experience. It's not something that stays with us. It comes and it goes and it ebbs and it flows. And like, I'm understanding that I asked to understand death more. I asked in my prayers that I would understand it more because I had lost my mother this year. That I wanted to, so it's being revealed to me because I asked to understand it more. So more experiences are coming where I have to understand it. That's the way this law of my being works. And I am beginning to understand it. I'm beginning to feel my mom right here. Like all of a sudden she'll come up and I'll just go, oh, my mom's here. You know, it's a new way of like communication, because sometimes I think we're trying to communicate in the old way, but it's a new way. So in order to bless everything, I think it helps with the healing of all these things, not just victimized things where we feel like somebody hurt us, but things like that where somebody leaves us and we're like trying to figure out why that happened and we don't have any idea, right? So to go into this idea of blessing, so that we don't have to stay stuck in the energy that's not helping the other person either or helping ourselves, you know. So St. Francis of Assisi said, it was easier to love God in all that was beautiful. The lesson of deeper knowledge instructed me to embrace God in all things. So if we choose the healing, blessing is the path. And that I'm more than the hurt of my past. So St. Francis was like saying, you can't just say God's in good things. If we're God and God's expressing through us and we're having all these experiences and different things, ups and downs and all flows and blah, 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 then God has to be in it all, because God doesn't leave us when we're having whatever experience we're having. So that light and that energy and that source doesn't leave us no matter what, seen and unseen. So I don't know. This has been quite a journey for the last couple of weeks. And I'm really moving through it in a good way. And I hope that by my sharing it with you, it helps you for whatever you're going through in your experience. But yet it's my experience. Like somebody wrote to me, I wrote up the blog on joy. And they were like, oh, well, you know, I need to blah, 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 blah. Well, yeah, you do. You need to do what you do, and I need to do what I do. And then what I say helps you, then that's great. If it doesn't, you have your own way, that's great. There's nothing wrong with any of it. We're all on the path, and we're all reaching the same place all the time, which is the light and the love of God within us. And we all get there in different ways. So let me tell you what the blessing is, because I think it's really beautiful. So I don't have it written down, but I mean, I have it written down here, but if you care to do this about anything in your life, and in the book, Greg Braden talks about it. He did it with his cat, because he lost his cat, kind of similarly to the way Patrick and I lost Merlin. And his name was Merlin. The cat's name was Merlin. And the whole story he told was the exact same story, so it came at a perfect time. So it can be something that simple, of losing an animal and you're feeling sad about it. And it's basically that you bless the names of those who suffered. So in his case, he blessed his cat. He blessed his cat. And then he blessed the names of those that inflicted the suffering. In his case, it was coyotes. So he blessed them. And then he blessed himself for witnessing the whole thing. And he said that he did it like in the privacy of his own home by himself, because he said it's a very emotional experience. And if you're willing to do it and you're willing to take the time with yourself to actually bless instead of curse, there's something that it actually, and I could feel it with this thing with Nora, I can feel my body just changing, and it just feels like I'm meshing with the experience, and it's all a part of me instead of me being over here looking at it and making some judgment on it. Because we can't expect to have those things and those lovely experiences we want in life and all of it, and the love and everything, if we sit in judgment of anything. So if this makes any sense, I just would invite us to just bless everything in our life. I think Emma Curtis Hopkins said it too. She said, bless everything, right? Bless, bless, bless. And whatever that word means to you, to me, it means to just sit there and just realize I'm a part of it all, and that it is good in some way, even if I can't see it, that it is divine. There's a divine process happening. It's just a feeling. It's a feeling. It's not just the word. When you start to say the word, the meaning of the word becomes known to you. So gratitude, yes, thank you, Loya. Feeling a gratitude, compassion. That's why the people in Tibet up on that mountain over there live so long, is because they practice compassion. They can practice compassion for everything. So these are some of the lessons I'm learning. So I just know that that when you do a blessing like this, that it doesn't necessarily change the world, but it changes you in the world. And then the world looks different. And I think that is what we're being asked to do now, is to find that gift, find that blessing within ourselves to be able to do that. And I think we're going to see how that unfolds in a greater and more magnificent way. So thank you so much for allowing me to share my process and to be able to stand up here and feel loved and all of that. And I love you so much, and I'm so grateful, and I always feel your guys' energy and support, and it feels so good. And I know that we all do that for each other, and it's a really beautiful thing. So mahalo, and that's all I have to say. Aloha. Okay. And now let Maria take it.
Come, they told me, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum, a newborn king to see, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum. Our finest gifts we bring, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum, to lay before the king, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum, rum-ba-bum-bum, rum-ba-bum-bum. So to honor him, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum, when we come, little baby, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum, I am a poor one too, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum. I have no gift to bring, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum, to lay before the king, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum, rum-ba-bum-bum, rum-ba-bum-bum. Shall I play for you, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum, on my drum? Mary nodded, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum. The ox and lamb kept time, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum. I played my drum for him, ba-dum-ba-bum-bum. I played my best for him. Ba-da-ba-bum-bum, rum-ba-bum-bum, rum-ba-bum-bum. Then he smiled at me, ba-da-ba-bum-bum, me and my drum.
Props. Thanks. Thanks, God. Oh, my goodness. You look beautiful today, by the way. I know. I can see you. Last week, we were talking about joy, of course, but we were talking about foreboding joy. And I got a lot of responses this week, which was really nice. I mean, they weren't responses like, that was wonderful. It was more like, wow, I really started thinking about foreboding joy. And the whole idea behind that is that sometimes we avoid joy because we're afraid of the other shoe dropping. And so if we can avoid it, or we can dress rehearse tragedy, then we can maybe avoid it. And just an FYI, it's not going to happen. Because we cannot avoid what is a part, as Rita so eloquently was saying, that it's just all a part of our experience about this idea of foreboding joy. And we don't have to do that. We can accept it, all of it. It's an interesting thing. Rita and I have been going through that this week with the loss. I don't even like that word. The gain of our beautiful light being. And it's okay. It's okay. I thought to myself, we put a little bit too much shame based on feeling like hurt or feeling pain. There's like, I got to get rid of that, and we'll get onto this, and we'll get, and maybe we don't. Maybe we can just sit with it for 5 seconds without trying to move on to the next thing. So I was thinking about that today. And I don't know about you, but during the Christmas season, all these thoughts start coming up. You start like having a memory. You're thinking, wow, how did that pop in there? You know, and you're like, you know, you sneeze and all of a sudden you're remembering your time in Thailand. I'm like, wow, what a mechanism. I'm not kidding you. I actually sneezed and I thought, I remembered a time in Thailand. I went, wow, we are infinite intelligence. It's just like this computer that, and we keep thinking we're going to erase it. And that's not our job to erase it. Our job is to live now in the moment. So I wanted to share a Christmas story with you since it is the holidays. And if you don't celebrate the Christmas, we all celebrate the holiday in our own way. But I debated whether or not to share this story, because it was very close to my heart, but it came up. And I got permission from my inner child to do this. And if any of you know me, when I work with my inner child, I ask permission to express. Because if you don't, that inner child will wreak havoc upon your life like you have never seen. Because that, yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. But I want to share this with you, and I don't know why, but I really want to be with it when I share it. When I was a little boy, I loved Christmas. My house was not set up for a Hallmark movie, by the way. I don't know how many of you had the Hallmark, and it's great if you did. And we'll talk about it. But I thought of this time, and I thought, unwrapping the gift and how long it takes sometimes to see the gift when something happens. So I'd love to tell you it's a ho, 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 and a, you know, lots of desserts and lots of joy, and it is at the end of it, but bear with me. So when I was a little boy, I was in charge of kind of the Christmas thing, of setting it up, making sure that, you know, when the tree was bought, which is usually on the 15th because it was real and it would be dry by the time of the 25th. I had it all down at 7. And I'm thinking, wow, I look back and I thought, that little boy was putting together Christmas since I can remember. And the tree was a real big deal for me. Huge deal. I mean, I even after everybody went to bed, there was four of us, my brother and myself and my mom and dad, I would just get it all done and just sit with the twinkling lights. And I was at such peace with those lights. Well, one cheery Merry Christmas, if you read my blog, you know where we're going. One Christmas, you know, let's just get the facts out. My dad, he was a raging, beautiful alcoholic who also had mental illness and all this stuff. So let's just put that out there so we don't have to worry about that. So he had some stuff he was working through. Well, that particular Christmas, and you always knew when it was going to happen because one eggnog turns into four, and then all of a sudden where we're decorating the tree, we're done finally. And then my dad had a rage attack, which means anything can happen, and we never know why. We just know it's going to happen. So we had to do what we usually do, dart for the car, grab everything, and get out of the house so we can be safe. You cheered up yet? I just want to know. There's nothing like a warm Christmas story to. So here's what happened, though. We darted out, and that was not the first time. But we're going somewhere very important with this story about this little boy who can teach us all a lesson. We took off, and then we came back, knowing that he most likely would be passed out. And we had it kind of timed. Nothing was moving in the house. But as we were turning the corner, we noticed, not Rudolph, but we noticed that our tree was in the middle of the street because he had had the little attack and then thrown the tree in the middle of the street. Well, I don't know about you, and I'm not getting into all the emotional stuff, but when you turn a corner and you see that, I know, right? But I want you to know right now, feel whatever you're feeling, but I'm not telling it so you can feel sorry for me. I want you to feel what this little boy as they turned the corner and saw this tree. And that would have been the first moment in life that I would have said, you know, Christmas sucks. But I didn't. I saw the broken branches and the broken ornaments. And the first thing that I thought was, is he asleep? And he was. And let's get the tree in. So my mom and I pulled and dragged the tree in the house, and I started putting it up, little by little. My little injured tree, my 6-foot injured tree, needed me to heal it while I healed myself. And I didn't want anyone around me. My mom went to sleep, and I sat with that little tree one by one, putting it together, putting the ornaments back on. And I made a vow to myself that no one would ever take away Christmas from me, no matter what. No matter what. So that little boy, as he put this tree back together and stood there, yeah, there was sadness. And boy, did my anger fuel me. Oh, my anger fueled me. You will never. Give me the bells. Give me the bells. Give me the bells. Give me my Santa. Give me this. I don't care. And I really sat with it as it was happening with this little boy. And I thought, I love you so much, Patrick. That little boy who defied everything that says you cannot take my joy away. There's a quote that says, the ego searches the loveliest garden to find a single thorn. The spirit searches the most desolate desert to find a single bloom. The ego searches the loveliest garden to find a single thorn. The spirit searches the desolate desert to find a single bloom. And I believe that this is what this story represents. That there was a little part of myself that knew that there was a bloom there, that I could do that. And this is what I wrote the other day. I found a gift of glasses. I found a gift that night through all the emotions of hurt, sorrow, and tons of anger. I found a part of me that night that would never settle again to have my joy destroyed by anyone. I took that gift with me throughout my life and have been successful for a good portion of my life's experiences. What did I gain from it? Where was the gift? Where's the gift? Oh, I told this story for years. Oh my God, I brought down every Christmas party for about, you get together with your friends and you think, okay, you think you didn't get your toys? What? Here's the Christmas story. And I'm not kidding you. It would be almost like, come on over to the party. We heard the Christmas story last year, the tree story. And why I say that is because sometimes I did. It was my identity for a lot of years. My story was my identity. The poor little boy story was my identity for a while. And now, as a proud parent of my inner child, I understand what that little boy has taught me. He's taught me about faith. And that no matter how horrible, no matter how dysfunctional, I found joy and I looked for it because I looked for the bloom. I didn't see all the time that there was a broken tree. I saw my opportunity to put my tree back together. So am I special? You're damn right I am. Yeah, so are you. So is each and every one of us. I just want to breathe in with you for a moment. I've processed this, so that's why I can share it with you. We are looking today to find, what did I really learn? I have resilience. I have love. And I have joy. And yeah, we were also talking about when you write about, you know, don't sit in the joy or wallow in the morbidity. A lot of people say, no, I need time to process. When we say don't wallow in the morbidity, I want to get something very clear to you. We're not saying don't feel the pain. But what we're saying is eventually the bloom will be there. And I found it. And this is a Christmas story that I am so proud of. Because I saw that little boy had an opportunity to go the other way. That little 8-year-old had an opportunity to never, ever, ever trust Christmas ever again. Never trust joy ever again. Never trust anyone ever again. And that little boy said, and here's the deal. I wasn't even a minister at the time. I was just a little boy that was infused with spirit that said, hey, come here, you just love bug. I'm going to take you through this, and you're going to learn from it. So I unwrapped that gift many years after that. It's nice to stand up here now and say, yeah, I found the gift. And now, actually, that night, I did not find the gift. I hated my dad for many, many years, at that tree and many other things. And then I turned around one day, and I said, if you can love the injured tree, you can love your injured dad, because he was very injured. Because somebody who is filled with light, like all of you here today, they don't throw trees in the middle of the street. They got to be in a lot of pain, man. That's when love comes in. That's when joy comes in. And that is what Christmas, to me, this year, is very different. And I appreciate the ability to be able to tell you this story. Because I really believe, do not go sprouting out stuff unless you ask that little part of yourself, is it okay that I share this? Because it's vulnerable and it's naked and it feels very, very alone in that moment. And you must ask permission. Are you willing to share this? Are you willing to trust all of these people that are standing in front of you in order to be an inspiration? So I will end with that. I will end with the idea that I came here and shared this to be an inspiration for you. An inspiration for you. Namaste. Yeah. What do other people do on Sunday mornings? Just curious.
I'm going to just take a moment, just if you don't mind, to just do a spiritual mind treatment
right now.
Thank
you. I appreciate that.
All right. Just to just settle us in this beautiful sharing and in everything that we might be feeling right now, knowing that behind it all, there is the power of God, the power of spirit, the power of love that can move us through anything at any time. And this was the most perfect example of that. And I know we each and every one of us, whatever we are experiencing, have that same inner child, that same power, that same light, that same love that guards and guides and protects us in every moment and shows up exactly when we need it, exactly when we require it. We are always, always, always supplied by spirit. It can never, ever, ever fail us. I know that and claim that for each and every one of us, and know that our lives are moving with ease and with grace and with love, and that that joy is behind everything, making itself known through our experiences when we are ready. And in the meantime, we have grace to fall back into. And I know we can and we do. And we're, like I said, we're always guided, we're always guarded, we're always protected. And we are love. That is what we are. And so I just give gratitude for this time together and for this manifestation of this word that I have spoken, and I just release it. I let it go with ease and grace into law, and let it be so as we affirm. And so it is. Thank you. Thank you.
Hello, everyone.
You're amazing. We're all amazing. Yeah.
Where do you go from there, huh, honey?
Well, now I know why he likes Christmas trees so much. Okay.
I'm obsessed. I have 32 in my home.
Okay, it's good. It's good. All right, so this is our time of giving and just loving our center and just giving from ourselves, appreciating all the gifts that we give to CSL Kauai, knowing that they are just helping the work move forward, helping the world, and helping us too. So all of us, because as we give, we receive. And so there is an affirmation in the program that we can read together. And it says, I freely and joyously give from the abundance and fullness of my overflowing wealth, knowing my gift goes with love as it touches and blesses Center for Spiritual Living Kauai, my life, and the world. And it does, and so it is. All right.
Gratitude before me, gratitude behind me, gratitude to the left of me, gratitude to the right of me. Gratitude above me, gratitude below me, gratitude within me, gratitude all around me. I'm so grateful, 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 I'm so grateful. Gratitude before me, gratitude behind me, gratitude to the left of me, gratitude to the right of me. Gratitude above me, gratitude below me, gratitude within me, gratitude all around me. I'm so grateful, 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 I'm so grateful. Gratitude before me, gratitude behind me, gratitude to the left of me, gratitude to the right of me. Gratitude above me, gratitude below me, gratitude within me, gratitude all around me. I'm so grateful, 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 I'm so grateful.
Did you know that each of you is such a blessing to the center? And we are, everybody at the center is so grateful for the gifts that you put in these baskets or send by the mail. Each of you is a blessing, and those blessings go out from the center into many other areas of life. And so I just bless what came in, and I bless what goes out. Yes. It's the energy of the universe. Mm. And so it is.
So it is.
And if you'll notice, there's been people dropping little things in our piggy bank. But it's not a piggy bank, is it? But it is a bank. So we have a building fund, and I just wanted to just say something about that. We, in about a year and a half, we, as you can see, we're expanding, and so we need to grow, and our kids need to be, even though it's a very cute title, Kids in the Kitchen, eventually we're going to have to get the kids in their own place. So that's what we're moving towards, but it's not necessarily all of the property. It's wherever we are will be our next move, and that's what this building fund is for.
Right,
everything to add to that.
And just so you know, it's been growing, and we started with nothing, and now we're up to $6,000, so it's pretty good, right?
Yeah.
And some of it came through separate donations, and some of it, a lot of it came through that little jar over there, so I think it's pretty awesome. Right.
So we still continue to sustain here, and we know that, but whatever beyond that, then we will start working our way towards our next evolution.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Children?
All right, children. Are they here? Where are they? They're here somewhere. Okay, well, while we get the children, let's have the practitioners that are going to serve today come forward. And as soon as I say that, the kids come out. But anyway, we'll get back to the practitioners in a minute. Here are the kids.
Oh, look at these. I solemnly swear that I am.
Wow.
Uh-oh.
Malia is actually walking up by herself. Wow, I love it.
She's, I don't need any carrying anymore
Malia.
Here.
Oh. And where's their trusty leader, Janice? Here she comes.
I bet you're thinking I'm going to read the shirt that you have on.
Yeah,
I solemnly swear that I am up to no good.
Right.
Welcome to Centers for Spiritual Living Kauai, where that old phrase, all's good, sometimes we vary.
Humor.
We do have it.
Yes, humor is good. We imagined a 11 and up room, elementary room, and a preschool room. That was our vision today. Today we talked about something, and do you remember we went over some of the concepts we've been going over the last few months, so I was going to see if the children wanted to share something they remembered. I know Anna remembers. No? Do you remember some of the concepts? You just don't want to say them? If I start you, will you finish? To know my
self is to know God.
Thank you.
To know myself is to know God.
So, yeah, that's... Yeah, one thing we talked about, and then we got into some creativity. We made some that we're going to throw back into the ocean if they're environmentally friendly, and yeah, had a great time.
Okay, so we're going to give you your blessing. Are you ready? It's in your program, everyone. You are amazing. You are perfect. You are magnificent. And we love you. Yay. And we send it out to all the children in the world. Thank you. Thanks, Janice. Yay. Okay, let's go back to the practitioners now. Where are they? Okay, so we have Reverend Diane. We have Roseanne. We have Dr. Peggy. We have Rob. If you can go to a practitioner that looks like that, why not? Okay, that'll be an interesting prayer. Anyway, if something's come up for you during the service, or if you just would like something in your life that you would like to know the truth about, please utilize this. You have the opportunity to have a gift of a spiritual mind treatment from these lovely beings of light and love, these practitioners. So enjoy that. Anything else?
I think that's
it. Do it all? Okay.
Have a beautiful day. Oh, yeah. The boutique's back there.
And
there you go. So yeah. Let's get on.
And if she's listening, we thank Marilyn Taylor for all the things
right,
that
for sending them over here. Yeah, thank you so much. All right, you ready? Let's have some peace on earth. Katie's song.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With love as a power, family all are we. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my joyous vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
And so we take this peace into our lives right here and right now and allow it to manifest in every single solitary situation that we are experiencing. Let peace be who we are on earth at all times. And I give gratitude for that, and I give gratitude for this time together and all the people that served today: Michelle LeMay, the Malama team, DJ Melissa and Maureen, Roseanne as practitioner today, the live streaming with Rob and Jonathan on sound, Ron Stover and his hospitality team, whoever they are back there, the flowers that were given to us by the beautiful Walt, and by, who's this one? Maria Christina, and by Arlena and Peter. Thank you so much for beautifying the center in that most wonderful way. And Maria and Christina for the music, thank you. And Luis for keeping the beat for us all the time. And the collection stewards, Michelle and Sue, and all the off-island contributors, all of you, mahalo, mahalo for being here. And Charles, I'm sorry I forgot you back there, but no, I did not. I never forget you, Charles. Thank you. All right. Well, I'm so grateful for this, and so grateful for this time that we've had together, knowing, like I said, that we take this feeling that we have right now, and we move through it, and we move it out into the world, and bring more and more light to the world and more expansion through ourselves. And so I just let that be. So as we say together, and so it is.
Shine. Shine. Each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth. Let it begin with me.
Yes. All right, we did it. I'm sorry.
I was going back to a different.
Boy, you look good.
No.
Thank you, Christine.
Thank you. You're magnificent. Thank you so much.
Can they hear us? I think they might. Anyway, tell them what we're doing here, Charles.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are on the live stream right here at CSL Kauai. All you have to do is go to the live stream and then go and press the IBM on the top right. You and I can chat. We can get some feedback to you throughout the CSL services on Sunday.
It's time.